Okay, in this lecture, we shall be looking at squares and roots of numbers. Please pay keen attention so you can get all that we have for you in this lecture. Now, let's begin. We said that in mathematics, the square of a number is the product of the number and itself. Whenever we talk about square of a number, what we are simply saying is the products of the number and itself, that is the multiplication of that number and itself. For instance, now we say the square of A, what is it? The square of A, which is denoted as A square, is the product of A and itself. That is A square equals to A times A. Take note of that. The square of a number is the product of that number and itself. If I say, what is the square of Philip? The square of Philip means Philip times Philip. The square of Daniel means Daniel times Daniel. So therefore, the square of A, which is A square, is equals to A times A. I hope you understand that. Now, let's look at the square of 6. What is it? The square of 6 is 6 square. That's how square is denoted. And it is equals to what? 6 times 6. Then 6 times 6, that gives us what? 36. That's what it means. I hope you understand squares of a number. Now, on the other hand, the square root of 36. Remember, we said the square of 6 is 6 times 6 and it gives us 36. Therefore, the square root of that 36 will give us 6. But this is how square root is represented. The square root of 36 is what? 6. Because the square of 6 is 36, then the square root of 36 is what? 6. So square root is like a reverse of squares. I hope you understand what we just explained. Okay, now, similarly, if you say, what is the square of minus 6? The square of minus 6 is minus 6 times minus 6. That is, minus 6 square is what? Minus 6 times minus 6. And that gives us what? 36. Because minus times minus is plus, right? So minus 6 times minus 6 is what? Plus 36. Therefore, it also means that the square root of 36, this 36 here and this one, because the square of minus 6 gave us 36, therefore the square root of that 36, which is square root of 36, is what? Is also minus 6. I hope you understand what we are trying to explain. The square, remember, the square of 6 gave us 36. Then the square of minus 6 also gave us what? 36. It therefore means that we can conclude that square root of 36 has two answers. And the two answers are what? Plus 6 and minus 6. Because the square of 6 gave us 36 and the square of minus 6 still gave us 36. So it means that the square root of 36 is equals to plus or minus 6. That's what we can draw from the illustration we just explained or we just showed. So it means that 36 has two roots and the roots are plus 6 and minus 6. Because 6 times 6 is 36. And minus 6 times minus 6 is what? 36. I hope you understand what we just explained. So now, let's give you a proposition. A proposition is like a statement that can be drawn as a conclusion. So this is what we mean. In mathematics, every positive number has one positive root and one negative root. Every positive number in mathematics, if you look at, for instance, the square root of 100, the square root of 100 has two roots. The first root is what? Plus 10. And the second root is what? Minus 10. Because plus 10 times plus 10 is 100. Then minus 10 times minus 10 is also what? 100. I hope you understand that. Okay. So, square root of 36, as we saw earlier, is equals to 6. Because 6 times 6 is what? 36. We also said that square root of 36 is what? Minus 6. Because minus 6 times minus 6 is what? 36 also. So in mathematics, every positive number has one positive root and one negative root. Okay. Now let's look at some further examples. The square of 9. What is it? The square of 9 is 9 squared, which gives us what? 9 times 9. And that is equals to what? 81. It therefore means that the square root of 81 is what? Of course, it's 9 plus or minus 9. Because every positive number has two roots. So the square root of 81 is equals to what? Plus or minus 9. Because minus 9 times minus 9 still gives us what? 81. Okay. The square of 3.4 is 3.4 times 3.4. And that gives us what? 11.56. It therefore means that the square root of 11.56 is what? Is plus or minus 3.4. Because every positive number has two roots. A positive root and a negative root. Okay, let's look at another example. The square of minus 3 is what? Minus 3 times minus 3. And minus 3 times minus 3 is what? Is 9. It therefore means that the square root of 9 is what? Is plus or minus 3. I hope you understand what we just explained. Okay, let's advance. Now, we're entering into perfect squares. Let's quickly give you a definition of what perfect squares are. Now, perfect squares are those numbers such that when you square root them, the result will give you a whole number. Any number such that whenever you take its square root, the result is always a whole number. That number is known as what? A square root. A perfect square, sorry, please. Any number such that whenever you take its square root, the result will give you a whole number is called a perfect square. Now, in other words, what we mean is that a number whose roots gives a whole number is always a perfect square. For instance, examples of perfect squares are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49. This is because if you check the square root of 1, square root of 1 gives us what? 1 plus or minus 1. Because 1 times 1 is 1. So the square root of 1 is 1. Now we said 4 is a perfect square. Why? Because the square root of 4 gives us plus or minus 2. Because if you check it, 2 times 2 is 4. Minus 2 times minus 2 is still what? 4. So we said that perfect squares are those numbers such that when you square root them, the result will give you a whole number. 9 is a perfect square because the square root of 9 is what? Plus or minus 3, and it's a whole number. 16 is a perfect square because when you square root it, the result is what? Plus or minus 4. 25 is a perfect square because when you square root 25, the result is what? Plus or minus 5, etc. If you check it now, 10 is not a perfect square because if you check the square root of 10, the answer is not a whole number. You can confirm that. Okay. I hope you understand what perfect squares are. Okay, I hope so. Let's advance. Okay. Let's just stop this lecture here by giving you a leisure work to play with. So that in the next lecture, we are going to show you how to evaluate square root of numbers. Now, the question here is, well, number one, is 36 a perfect square and why? We told you that perfect squares are those numbers such that when you square root them, the result will be what? A whole number. So the question is 36 a perfect square? And tell us why. The second one is 10 a perfect square? Tell us why. The third one is, why is 5 not a perfect square? Okay, we'll see you in the next lecture. In the next lecture, we'll look at squares and root of numbers, lecture 2. Here, we are going to teach you how to evaluate the square root of a number. Thank you very much.